What's up, infected? Welcome to the Kwarenteen. I got another unboxing for you, Star Trek Frontiers. Now, this isn't a Kickstarter or anything like that. It's just a figure. I just got it, so might as well unbox it. Now, if you don't know, Star Trek Frontiers is basically a retheming and, from what I understand, some things are reworked of Mage Knight, which I actually do thoroughly enjoy Mage Knight. I don't have any of the expansions or anything, but I do very much enjoy Mage Knight. But anybody who watches my show knows that I'm a big sci-fi nerd and I love Star Trek. Next Generation is probably my favorite sci-fi thing ever. Followed probably by like Battlestar Galactica, but whatever, I'm not going to get into that. But so I've been wanting to get this for quite a while. I managed to find a really good deal on it and it showed up in the mail today. So figured why the hell not? Let's just do an unboxing of it. So here's the fancy schmancy box. And from what I understand, it's mainly really just almost the exact same game. I think they have away missions is pretty much the only, I cannot find a nipple here to cut. We'll do it this way then. But apparently it adds like away missions. But other than that, it's really the same exact game. So, and again, Star Trek nerd. So I've been wanting to get this for probably, I don't know, six, 7 months now. Pretty much since it came out. I don't remember when it came out. So, the one thing that did worry me about this is because I'm always going to play as Picard because Picard is the epitome of a Starfleet captain, and I can't stand Kirk. But, and the Enterprise D is one of my favorite Enterprises. Enterprise E is, of course, my all-time favorite. But, the problem that I can foresee that I may have is the fact that, as Picard, I can still just totally sack stations and stuff. I could be a total jerk, but, that's future me's problem, I guess. So we got this. Ooh, this is a much nicer insert than Mage Knights. Like, I just showed Mage Knights, and everything's just kind of thrown in there for Mage Knight. Come on. Because of how the insert is, which the insert for Mage Knight is nice, don't get me wrong. It's just not as nice as this is. I won't need that anymore. So we got, just like in Mage Knight, you have how many movement points it takes to move over these types of terrains, but the difference is there's no day-night side. It's always the same, so that's interesting. I knew that was a thing. Then you have, of course, the scoreboard and the reputation meter going between good and evil, and then what you get from all your things here. You know, rather than having two federations, I wish they would have had, like, why can't I remember what they're called all of a sudden? The Spoonheads, Gul Dukat. They were aligned with the Dominion. I can't remember. But yeah, so you have your two rule books. You have the walkthrough and the full rule book. And yeah, I mean, it looks like it reads pretty much just like the other one. But yeah, I wish I would have been able to, wish you could play as them. That would be pretty cool. But I'm pretty sure you can have them in your ship. And I'm not sure how I feel about this box. I kind of like it because it's not your standard box, but see, as you see here, I don't know if it's picking up in the camera, this is already ripping just from the one time I've opened this box. So that might be an issue, but whatever, that's future me's problem. So you got your tiles. They're not double-sided. They all should have. Okay, yeah, so you have the Tier 1 and Tier 2, or whatever it's called. Same thing with Mage Knight. You have green and then, like, yellow bases. But it looks like the cities in this are actually Borg cubes. So that's interesting. Looks like Earth or Class M planet, whatever. So I'm hoping this winds up being just as good, if not better, due to a flavor win. As Mage Knight, because like I said, I really enjoy Mage Knight. It's one of my go-to solo games if I ever want to play some games and I don't have anybody to play with. But I'm hoping this is better overall just because Star Trek is awesome. So, there's all those. Let's try to get these. There we go. And I'll deal with those later. I'll deal with all those in a minute. Oh no, okay, cool. I was gonna say, because Mage Knight has these really cool plastic things. These almost look like rupees, but I guess they're, looks like, oh, they're data chips, okay. Yeah, so you have your data chips, which are basically the resource, same as the crystals from, come on, same as the crystals from Mage Knight. We'll throw those over there. So that's neat. These dice are pretty cool. I'll go ahead and pull one out and we'll show one. So you have your different symbols here, which really it doesn't matter what the symbol actually is. It's just, it's mainly you're looking for the color is really it. So whatever those symbols are supposed to represent, like looks like phaser, don't know, who knows. All right, and then these, I'm really not sure at all. Oh, these are the markers, okay, I'm dumb. So these are control markers. I'll just have them out like this. So like when I control something, if I'm playing as, oh no, I always play as red, so I will probably wind up playing as the Klingon Empire, but either way. So, you know, if I am Enterprise, the Enterprise D, I would put this in this area. Oh, well, in this case, I'd put it here to show that I control that space station. So that's what those are. And I thought, yeah, there's this. Don't know what that is. You have the Klingons. Looks like a bunch of Klingons on there. Okay, you have, okay, everybody has one. That's probably their, your, each player's reputation track. So let's put those in there. I'm gonna have to separate those anyways, but that'll be done off camera. So I'm not, there goes my phone. I'm not going to go through all of these, but if you've seen Mage Knight, what the hell? Why are there transporters? Like all these tokens, both of them have the same, both sides have the same picture, but it looks like a transporter room. So I'm not really sure what that's supposed to be. What are these? These also are the same picture on both sides. So I'm not really sure what those are supposed to be, but whatever. So we will, they'll probably have something, okay, I'm not gonna fight with that right now. They probably have something to do with the away missions. So you have, yeah, you have, just like Mage Knight, you have your level up tokens, and then once this, once you level up, you would get this, and then now that's a new crew that you have. So you have these for each crew. I'm not gonna show both sides of everything, but you get the idea. So it gives you, here, if you're at level 9 and 10, you can have four armor, I think, is what that would be, because I think that's what it is in Mage Knight, and then you have a hand limit of 7 is what that would mean. So it takes 4 damage to do 1 damage to you, if that makes sense. A little bit more to it than that, that's a very primitive way to explain it. So that way, if anybody does watch this, you know, you're not going, oh, but no, that's not how that works. So you have Borg spheres, and then what they do on the one side, then Borg cubes, if I move my fat finger out of the way, Borg cubes with everything they do. And I'm not going to go through each and every one of these tokens here. Yeah, so you got a bunch of Borg cubes and spheres. Oh, there's another thing down there. Okay. Then you have, what is that? Okay, that's what I thought. It's a Romulan outpost. And it's like a Romulan warbird. And then, like, for that Romulan warbird, oh, they're not all just warbirds, they're just warbirds on one side. So there's Romulan ships. So There's that. I wonder if that means if you're the Romulan ship over here. No, that's Klingon. No, that is also Klingon. So is it just Klingons? And unless I'm crazy, those both look like Klingon ships to me. Huh, whatever. I guess that would make sense then. More Borg cubes. Alright, we'll put that there. Let's see, we got more Romulans. Looks like we got planets. I don't remember what class planet that is. More Borg spheres, different class of planets. More Romulan outposts, more planets. Another more planets, and now it looks like we have possibly Federation. No, God, that's... I cannot for the life of me remember. Kardashians. No, not Kardashians. There we go. Brain. So we got Kardashian outposts. Neato. And... I don't know what the hell that's supposed to be. Looks like maybe a planet? I guess. But yeah, so there's a planet there. Got more outposts. It's like more of the same. More gas giants, more planets. So there's that. And I'll divvy those up later. I'm not worried about them. All right. So we got, oh, for the level up. When you level up, sometimes you're going to, and I hit, oh, sorry, that was my refrigerator. But when you level up, you'll get to draw two of these tokens, and you're going to get to choose one, and they'll have a special ability that allows you to do something fancy. So you got some Klingons. Ah, I feel like a failure. I can't remember for the life of me. I'm 99% sure that is... I'm wanting to say it's a Nikvar Klingon ship, but I... cannot for the life of me remember. I'm more of a Federation guy, so I don't remember. But sorry, my cat won't shut up either. So, and the wife is giggling over it. And then we got these, which I'm assuming are score markers. They'll go on that board. So there's this. Now let's go over. I'm just gonna pull out one of the board cubes because they're all exactly the same. But you have a Borg cube, which are replacing the cities in Mage Knight. Whoa, and here I'm about to throw it to the ground. And they have these little hero click bases that you would set it to. Depending on whatever difficulty you wanted, you'll set it to something. And then that's what just the city would do. And then we will look at these here. So we got, of course, the Enterprise D, the science vessel. Fancy. Then we have the Defiant. Would have liked to have seen, like, if I hope they come out with expansions with just different types of ships, like, because I will always play the Enterprise E if that ever comes out. And I know I'm getting this wrong. I'm 99% sure this is a Klingon ship. And I'm wanting to say it's the Nikvar, but I don't remember. And then, of course, a Klingon Bird of Prey. And so it looks like it is Klingons and Federation. So there's those. I'll put those back later. So we'll just take these and throw them here. So now, lastly, we're going to go through the cards. Anybody who's played Mage Knight knows that there's 16 million cards in this game. Because it's a weird combination of, like, deck builder meets, like, adventure game. It's weird. Oh, these are resealable. Huh. I probably won't use them though, but I might. That's not bad. So I'm gonna put them over here, all nice like, and maybe reuse those. So yeah, you have the turn order, which gives you, if you get this, you're just gonna go first, but you don't get anything fancy. But if you take, you know, six, you get a special ability, or any of the other ones, you're gonna get a cool, usually a once per round ability, or once per Well, in Mage Knight, you get like a once per day or night ability, whereas here, I don't know how that's going to work. It's probably like a once per round ability. So there's that. Throw that bad boy there. And I'm on the fence if I want to keep these sleeves here. I probably will not, but just in case. So these are, looks like you have your different board cubes. So there's those, and it just has what each level does. Oh, there we go. And then on this side, it has what the little symbols, which the game is very symbol heavy, but yeah, this should, yeah, tell you what all those symbols are. So there's that. But here's the cool thing about Mage Knight. If you're unfamiliar with it, you have, of course, like this, all this is just reference cards. So you have these that tell you, you know, the scenarios, how they score, co-op and solo scenarios, how you score with that, achievement bonuses at the end of the game. So for bonus points, if you're playing with other people, and then it gives each player has a card, and it's a double-sided card that has all of their upgrade tiles and explains what those symbols mean if you're not familiar with it. So that's pretty cool. But then every symbol in the game, and all the backs of these should be the same, every symbol in the game has a card. So a Romulan Warbird, this is what it does. Read this, it explains everything. So most of the time, if you ever have any questions, all you should have to do is pick up this stack of cards and look through this and go, okay, a class H planet, okay, class M, and a class K planet. Okay. Oh, there's two class K, class L planet. Oh, wow. There's lots of them. Okay. But anyways, oh, there is Dominion in here. That's a Dominion starbase. That's right. Not a Cardassian starbase. But yeah, you get the idea. So it's pretty cool. So that way, a lot of your questions should be answered just by looking at one of those cards there. All right, so let's look at the backs of these. Not sure why these are yellow, unless, okay, these are probably just, these are crew, I guess. Yeah, Miles O'Brien. They're stills from the show, and a lot of people get pissy with, oh, they use stills from the show. And I don't mind it, honestly. It was 7 of 9. I actually hated that character. Oh, wow, there's lore. Holy shit. I'm going to nerdgasm all over the place playing this. I really hope it winds up being... Honestly, as long as it winds up being... Oh, that's what it is. These are the elite people, like in Mage Knight, and these are the standard. That's why they're gray. But anyways, I'm hoping I enjoy this at least as much as Mage Knight. And wait a fucking second. Is Miles O'Brien an elite crew member? I mean, he's pretty badass, but still. You know, Worf, Data. I always thought he looked goofy, but whatever. So why is the rest of the bridge crew of the Enterprise even Riker? And they're standard, but Miles is whatever. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like Miles, but I don't think he deserves to be I don't think he deserves to be an elite crew member, but whatever. All right, so what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to tell you right now, the backs of these are exactly the same, because this is kind of where the deck builder part comes in. I don't know what that's for. Ah, USS Defiant, that's for your ship. So, yeah, the backs of these should be pretty much identical, except for probably one card for... Yep, Nygvar, I was right. Haha. But anyways, you get one card for each ship. I'm sorry, I feel like I've reclaimed my nerd badge. Right, but there's no Enterprise E? Hang on. They all have a card so far as I can see. Yeah, there it is. Okay. Yep. Oh, D. I don't know why I just said E. But yeah, Enterprise D. So there's your ship cards. And this is where you would put any of the data chips you have. You'd put it on here, stuff like that. So as you see, the backs of these are identical. So what we'll do instead is, I'm going to have to sort through these anyways, but you have relics, it looks like. That's why they got the gold. I'm trying to do this So, yeah. And then you have damage cards, which they all look exactly the same. And they work just like in Mage Knight. Basically, you get these and you add them to your discard pile, so they're future use problem. But the problem is, once you wind up getting them, they're useless cards. And that might be wind up being a problem. But maybe when I shuffle it, it won't be as big of a deal, but whatever. Yeah, they wind up being useless cards, and if you ever draw a hand, these are basically spells, it looks like. But if you ever draw a hand of nothing but them, then you die and basically waste your turn. And it's because this game is a puzzle, an efficiency puzzle, is bottom line what this game actually is. So, you know, having a turn where, oh, I have a bunch of wounds in my hand is actually a big, big deal in this game. So, yeah, you have these are... Maybe those aren't... Yeah, those look like spells. So these are just your abilities. So the way this game works, if you don't know the way Mage Knight works, is if I play this card, it'll just give me, for free, just two move. Or if I use a yellow from the dice, it'll go here. And I would get four move. Or if I have a yellow data cube or gemstone from Mage Knight, I can also put that here and activate the bottom. You can only ever use one die. So you have to try to manage your resources and try to get what you need to play. But however, I can also just play this card sideways instead, and it will just give me one of pretty much anything but like ranged attacks, which I'm guessing, yeah, long range attacks. So like photon torpedoes. So, and that's kind of the way it works. So this game, like I said, winds up becoming Cisco. Winds up becoming a game of efficiency is really what it is. I'm guessing everybody starts with their own basic deck. Picard. That's who I will just wind up playing most of the time. But they're all stills from the show. And I don't remember if I actually said this, but a lot of games get grief from, you know, oh, they use stills from a show. I don't mind them. I actually, if it's from a series that I like, I actually don't mind the stills from the show. I actually like them because I don't expect them to, you know, if you're making a game for Star Trek, I don't expect you to go through and get new art and, you know, draw comic book style artwork and blah, blah, blah. Use stills from the show. You got them. Why not? So that, along with my incessant ramblings there, that is my unboxing for Star Trek Frontiers. Super excited to play this. Again, big Star Trek nerd. But that's it. So I will see you guys next time in the Kwarenteen.